Okay, in this video I want to show you how to combine the fundamental theorem of calculus and the chain rule to get some pretty strong results. You sometimes get problems like compute the derivative of the integral from 3x to x squared of e to the minus s squared ds. And at first glance this looks horrible. You know, how are you ever supposed to find that integral? And then once you have find that integral, how are you supposed to take its derivative? You know, in fact, we know that the integral does make sense. We know that there is an antiderivative of e to the minus s squared. We just don't know the formula for it. So let's let f of x be the antiderivative of little f of x, which is e to the minus x squared. So we are trying to take the derivative of the integral from 3x to x squared of f of s ds. And that's the derivative. Well, we use the second fundamental theorem of calculus and say to do this integral from 3x to x squared, we just take big F of x squared minus big F of 3x. Now, we don't happen to know a formula for big F, but that's okay, because now we apply the chain rule. The way you take the derivative of big F of x squared is you take F prime of x squared times the derivative of x squared. And the derivative of big F of 3x is F prime of 3x times 3. And now here comes the magic. Big F is an antiderivative, so the derivative of big F is little f. So you just plug it in. And since f of x is e to the minus x squared, this gives you e to the minus x to the fourth times 2x minus e to the minus 9x squared times 3. And there's your answer. In general, if you're ever given problems that look like find the derivative of the integral from, let's call it, g of x to h of x of f of s ds, you say, oh, that's the derivative of big F of h of x minus big F of g of x. And you don't worry about the fact that you don't know a formula for big F, because you're going to take its derivative, and you do have a formula for the derivative of big F. It's little f. So this is always going to give you f prime of h of x times h prime of x minus f prime of g of x times g prime of x, and that's going to be f of h of x times h prime of x minus little f of g of x times g prime of x. So you often run into these kinds of problems, and by combining the chain rule with the second fundamental theorem of calculus, we're not actually using the first fundamental theorem. We're using the second fundamental theorem. We get the answer. In fact, this is a backdoor way of seeing why the first fundamental theorem is true. If you believe that every function has an antiderivative, and for that you really do need to go through the proof of the first fundamental theorem, but if you believe that antiderivatives exist, then the derivative of the integral from a to x of f of x f of s ds, well, that's the derivative of big F of x minus big F of a. The second fundamental theorem of calculus says you find an antiderivative and you plug in at the endpoints, and that's how you do an integral from one spot to another spot. And that's f prime of x minus 0, because this is a constant, doesn't depend on x, so its derivative is 0, and that's little f of x. So that's another way of understanding the first fundamental theorem of calculus. Once you have the second fundamental theorem of calculus, the first fundamental theorem of calculus comes almost for free.